For the last 3 days, we've been putting on a virtual conference with thousands of people watching, and it's called Grow With Video. And in this video, I wanna show you the full setup of how we're pulling this off and how we're making it happen. Let's go.
You gotta just press record.
My name's Tony with Think Media, and we're here on the main stage, and this is where a lot of the main content is actually delivered throughout the entire conference, but we're bringing people in from Zoom, other rooms in this building, so I'm gonna take you to the switcher where all the magic happens. On our way to the switcher room, we actually have a confidence monitor, which really is meant to give confidence to the person on the main stage here. They can actually see the Zoom guests that we've brought on so they can talk right to them. And we have a camera set up right next to it, so it looks like they're looking right down the lens. It's also a spot where they can see what's actually going out to the live stream, which is so invaluable for giving confidence to your speakers on the main stage. This room that we're going to right now, like I just said, is a switcher room. And we have a lot of things coming on in here, so don't get intimidated, but we have a TV here, we have a computer, and we have the switcher. Now, we can monitor all of the different things we're bringing in here through this TV that's coming into this switcher. And with one press of the button, we can switch from any input source that we're bringing in. So we have something like Zoom that's in the bottom right corner here. We can bring that in through another computer and bring our guests in. And that's how we're accomplishing bringing virtual guests with a high level interactivity when they're bringing their sessions. So one of the cool things about this is we can do a 50-50 split between Sean on our Studio A main stage and our guest in Zoom to create a really highly interactive Q&A with the live chat. One of the other sources that we're bringing in is a software called ProPresenter. It's our software how we control all of our video assets that we're playing on the virtual conference during the live stream. It's also how we are actually doing overlays. We have some fun games we're doing. So we're really utilizing ProPresenter as one of our sources here. So for example, this stream starting soon screen will actually be coming from ProPresenter and going out to the live stream. We also are bringing in four camera angles. Now, our first three are actually in our main studio, Studio A, which you just saw in our main stage area. And Omar from our team actually made a video breaking down that full setup. So if you want to check it out, you can click the card above or check the description below. So up here, we actually have our sound booth. We have a lot of these guys that are like handling the transitions and mixing all the sound for the live stream. Everything's coming into this soundboard here and being mixed properly so it sounds great on stream. It's at the same level as our guests we're bringing in. And there's really the only way to do it is through a mixing console to make sure you get that consistent audio. And the reason why using a soundboard like this is so important is actually to have consistent audio levels. It's one of my biggest pet peeves with live streams or online videos is where you're listening to something, it's really quiet, and then all of a sudden the audio just jumps up really loud and almost like makes your ears bleed. So we just want to make sure it's a consistent audio level because you want a really immersive experience for your viewers so they're not distracted at all and they can really soak up the content that you're bringing to them. Let's go over and take a look at Studio B. It's also where we're gonna see the final destination of our live stream. So on the way to Studio B, we actually have a lot of SDI cables running the length of the building because if you try to use HDMI over a long distance, you actually can lose signal. And SDI is the best cable to use if you're running anything over 100 feet. I would say you wanna make sure you're using SDI cables. So here is our Studio B. It's a little crazy right now because we've been just doing at the end of a 3-day conference, but we have a second setup in here that makes it just feel a bit more homey. My intention with this design was to make it feel like we're at home with the viewers. We're hanging out in their living rooms with them. So it was a powerful idea to have all these lights, have this camera set up here so that it just feels more natural for the viewer to engage with us here on an online conference. This room is also our final destination for the stream. So we have our final output here into this PC. We're actually using a software called vMix to stream this out to YouTube that then goes into our virtual conference app that we're doing. It's also the place where we can read chat, we can kind of put some last minute overlays on top of the stream if we want to send any last call to actions, or we've been doing this fun game where we give event codes and they get points for putting those codes in the app. So we do that all here at the final stop of our vMix computer. So that is our full setup. If you wanna watch Omar's video I mentioned earlier where he talks about all the cameras in this setup, you can click on the screen right now and I will see you in the next video.